The year is 1853. Cuba is currently under the control of the Spanish Empire, and many of her citizens yearn for freedom. On January 28th of this year, a baby boy was born to a poor Cuban family in Havana. His name was Jose Marti. And although it was unapparent to his family and the rest of Cuba, he would become one of the greatest leaders of Cuban independence. An artist from a young age, Marti would grow these talents to later include literature and poetry. In one of his poems, he wrote, "Like bones to the human body, the axle to the wheel, the wing to the bird, and the air to the wing. So is liberty the essence of life. Whatever is done without it is imperfect." During his adolescent years, he would go on to write several political pieces in support of the 10 Years' War for Cuban freedom that had broken out in 1868. Due to the influence of his writings and their anti-Spanish sentiment, Marti was exiled to Spain. Undeterred, Marti continued his literary career at both the Central University of Madrid and the University of Zaragoza. After receiving his degree, he continued to write in Mexico and Guatemala. During his time in Guatemala, he became a professor and married Carmen Zayas Bazan. With the end of the 10 Years' War, Marti was allowed to return to Cuba. Once there, Marti attempted to become a lawyer, but this was forbidden by the Spanish government, and instead, he was forced to work as a teacher. Once Marti was back in his homeland, his past contempt for Spanish rule in Cuba returned stronger than ever, which led him to conspire against the Spanish government. This resulted in him being exiled a second time, but this time, America would be his new home. In New York City, he wrote arguably his best work, Our America. This piece would embody his political theory, arguing for Latin American unity. It is the time of mobilization, of marching together, and we must go forward in closed ranks, like silver in the veins of the Andes. Along with this book, he ascended to a leadership position in the Cuban Revolutionary Party and returned to Cuba in 1895, accompanied by a large group of Cuban revolutionaries, all with the goal of liberating Cuba of Spanish oppression. Allied with these revolutionaries, Marti would combat Spain in Dos Rios. During this skirmish, Jose Marti, the man who inspired all of Cuba, gave his life for his country. Although he was never able to see his country liberated, his death only fueled the fire of Cuban resistance. He became a martyr for the cause, and in 1899, Cuban revolutionaries, with the aid of the US, eventually succeeded in ousting the Spanish. He is still honored as a hero and revered as one of the greatest men in Cuban history. A memorial to him still stands in Havana, Cuba, and the song Guantanamera is inspired by his poem Versos Sencillos.
Coltivo una rosa bianca.